It's good to praise. Praise our Lord, amen. We're getting near the time of the year when we celebrate our God's death on the cross and resurrection. And it's a good time to reflect on a question: who can I trust? You see, all of us have to trust somebody sometimes. We trust our friends. You know, they let us down. Trust our family, even they let us down. But we are celebrating today, we're celebrating Easter, a God who says he'll never leave us or forsake us.
Amen.
That's our God. You see, when Adam was lost in sin, God said, I'm going to raise up a Savior and I'm going to save you. And Israel was lost in sin. And God said, I'm going to raise up a Savior and I'm going to save you. Came back from Babylon, lost again in our own city. This is our forefathers here. And God said, I'm going to raise up a Savior and I'm going to save you. And then when people least expected it, when they're under oppression, people all have given up hope. God sent his Son, Christ, into the world to save us. But you see, he wasn't the Savior that we wanted. He wasn't our kind of Savior. He didn't do the things we wanted. He didn't talk the right way. He didn't talk religious talk. So the people of God, the people who came before us, whipped him, beat him, and killed him. And right then, God probably would have been justified in saying, okay, that was your chance. That's it. I sent you a Savior and killed him. Our God is a God who keeps up his promises. Our God is a God we can trust. Our God is a God we can depend on. That's our God. And you see, because our Lord Jesus Christ suffered so much, because he was beaten and died on the cross for our sins, it's only through our Lord Jesus Christ that we can have life. And I want to encourage all of us that if we fall away a little bit, if we're not walking as we should, that tonight's the night to come back. Our Lord is never going to leave us or forsake us. But he wants us to be our Lord. It means our leader, the one who's in charge. Because he didn't die on the cross so that we could just have a half-hearted attitude towards him. He died on the cross to give us life. So even when we're singing, your worship with us great. But don't leave here unless you're reconciled with God. God gives it freely to anyone who asks. But you gotta want him. You gotta want to have the change. You gotta want to be the leader of your life. You're gonna want to have this new life. Let's just keep worshiping. Let's worship for the things he's done.
Done.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Erica asked me to come up here and do a testimony, and the first thing I thought was, Lord, what should I say? Where should I even begin? And I was praying, and I thought I would talk about something that I was battling with before salvation and in the midst of salvation, and that was depression. At about the age of 17, I joined the United States military, and it was then that I actually began to fall into the depths of despair and depression, and I was seeking love and acceptance and friendship in all the wrong places. And God was, during that period, was really trying to break me. He was really trying to grow me, to transform me, and to make me into the woman of God that He was trying to make me into. And through that, I came to realize that God wanted me to have more than a head knowledge of Him, but to begin to surrender my whole mind, heart, and will unto Him. And God was showing me that before then, I only had a head knowledge of Him. The only thing I was doing was, I was going to church, but my heart wasn't really in it. And I speak about the military because that was the time when God was really building that character in my life, and that was such a hard time for me. I battled with depression, and I realized now that God was breaking me. And even after I got out of the military, I'm still battling with depression. And I began to think, something's wrong with me. It's not spiritual to be depressed. It's not spiritual to always walk around with this void, this silent, this silent depression. I didn't have anybody to talk to. I didn't think anybody would really understand. And I'm just here to tell you that if that's something you're dealing with, even in your salvation, God has not left you. It doesn't make you unholy. It doesn't make you unspiritual. It doesn't mean that God is not with you. It's a process. And God is trying to bring you to perfection. So if you're dealing with that, don't be ashamed to talk about it. Just because you're saved and you see everybody's walking around and they're acting like everything's okay, they're highly favored and they're blessed in the Lord, and you're walking around and underneath you're suffering inside. Find somebody to talk about it with. Find somebody to go to. Don't suffer in silence. Now, I realized that, well, I think about Psalm 57:2, which says, I cry out to God Most High, who fulfills His purposes for my life. And I know that through it all, God has been trying to fulfill the purpose that He has for me. I have more joy now than I've ever experienced. And that's because I began to talk about the things that I was going to with people that God brought in my life that I could talk about it with. And I found out that I wasn't unholy and that I wasn't so unspiritual, but there were other people who were going through the same thing. And because it was kind of taboo to talk about it, they didn't. But when you begin to talk to other people, you find out that they're suffering from the same things, and in that, there's healing. And so I would say that if that's something you're dealing with, if it's depression you have, you can't even explain where it's coming from. It may be because of a bunch of different factors in your life. There could be a lot of things going on that's causing it. But more than anything, if you're dealing with it, God wants to use it to bring you into right relationship with Him, to bring you closer in your walk with Him. And I say, hold on. Hold on and continue to seek God, and He will bring you through it. He will raise you up. He will begin to give you that joy that you so desire. Don't give up. That is an awesome God.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
God's trying to do something in your heart tonight. Ask that you'd let him. If you're singing with us, that Lord, you are my song. Let him be your Lord. And let him be your joy, your song. I don't know what the situation is in your life right now. I just know in my life it's really easy to fall away really quickly. And if God's tugging at your heart right now to say, and if he's saying, no, I'm here, I'm waiting. Don't keep our Lord waiting. Shine the light of the world.